Okay, note to self. Get a tripod so you don't have to hold your phone. Hi, welcome to Synergy of Life. I'm Marantha. Today is Sunday, and I hope you're having a blessed and restful day. I wanted to give you a quick update on the OMAD experiment I'm doing for 1 week, which is one meal a day. And I'm experimenting because I found YouTube videos 6 months to a year ago and was completely interested, since I already eat that way, mostly 1 to 2 meals a day. It would vary, and sometimes eating very little even on the one day because I'm just not hungry, and then being super famished maybe 2 or 3 days later. But following my cycles, my eating cycles, which thankfully I got out of thinking that I had to eat 3 meals a day and snacks, and oh my gosh, I think that's where I made a huge mistake in about 4.5 years ago, and I gained a ton of weight. So I'm now, and I developed some sensitivities that I didn't have before. Interestingly, to grain, according to my naturopathic doc and my doc, I've always had a grain intolerance. It's just that when I was younger, my digestive system was very strong and it was really not noticeable, but it was. I had a few incidents when I was younger that were horrible, but I just chalked it up to, oh, I just had a baby, so it must be cramps from that, but actually probably wasn't. But anyway, moving forward, so I've lost 1 pound after day one, 2 pounds after day two, and now I'm up to, I lost 0.7 pounds after day three. I'll take it. So one thing I have to be very mindful of is making sure I get enough calories and that they're healthy calories and that my meals are varied. So today, I'm not showing you what I'm making because I'm not making it yet, but I will be. But I'm going to be doing sweet potatoes, some baked fish, maybe salmon or chicken, and then a big salad. An avocado or half avocado, but probably the whole one since that's my source, one of my sources of fat. And I did have some good Italian roast Starbucks coffee with heavy cream, which is one of my just favorite starters of the day. But I don't start with it every day because I don't want to get hooked on coffee again because I got off of it. So I just do it once in a while. Like today, I felt like I really needed it. I've been kind of oversleeping. I think something has been trying to jump on me all week and just hasn't taken hold. And as the day moves forward today, I feel like I'm a lot better, and I don't have an underlying headache, which was not a headache for lack of water because I've been drinking like 1/2 to 3/4 to almost a gallon a day on some days. So I don't think that's the issue. So, anyway, I want to give you that update, and I wanted to say also thank you for subscribing and giving me a thumbs up. I am new to this in that I'm doing videos more often. I'm not so new to it is that I started a YouTube channel like 9 years ago and just didn't know, really what to do or how to do it. And it became sort of laborious. And so I just decided right now, I just decided that, I think I said this before, I'm going to do live videos mostly and unedited. Boy, I can't speak this morning. So that's what I'm going to be, doing. I'm going to focus on various topics. Your feedback is very much welcomed. And that's all I wanted to say. Okay, so on a different subject, I listened to a podcast from Eric Worre, and he was interviewing Daniel Goleman, who has written many, many books over a long time on emotional IQ. And I remember reading some of his books a while ago, and it's really nice to be reintroduced because his wife, Okay, let me just put it in front of me. His wife's name is Tara Bennett Goleman, and she's written a book called Emotional Alchemy. So I'm going to be getting that book, and it's really important that you are at least aware of some of these principles that happen in our lives, because see, IQ is kind of like a fixed thing. You can't really change that. And interestingly, most people that have like a high academic IQ aren't the ones that are successful at businesses and other things in life. It's usually the people that have a higher emotional IQ. And that you can change. That you can change. You can learn and you can grow with it. So that's pretty exciting, right? So I'm going to focus on some of that since entrepreneurship is one of the things I'm very passionate about, helping people to learn how to do for themselves. And this is just one of the tools, one of the many tools. But I encourage you to get the book. I'm going to get the book. I'm going to look on Amazon. If any of you find it at a better price somewhere else, let me know. I also sometimes use Barnes and Noble, kind of like it better than Amazon. Just because I want to support Barnes and Noble, right? So, anyway, I just wanted to put that out there to you. So, if you get the book, let me know that you got it. Maybe we can read it together. That would be truly awesome. And I wanted to put that out there. So, we'll be talking more about that later. But right now, it's Sunday, and I want to sign off right now and get on with my day. Love you guys much, and I hope to see you soon. All right, thanks. Bye. Where's the off button? It's a big red button in front of me. Would this be a blooper? Okay. Bloop. Okay. All right, this is a goodbye.